This is an update in my continuing coverage of KIC 8462852, or Tabby Star, for October 7th, 2017. The star is currently at nominal brightness, having, at least for now, come out of its most recent dip. It's anyone's guess when the next could come, though given how active the short-term dips have been lately, I would not be surprised to see more in the coming weeks. There has been a sort of odd phenomenon going on in the media the last few days that people have been asking me to address. Usually the media is quick to jump to the alien conclusion with a story like this because it makes for good clickbait headlines. In fact, I originally started this channel with a video on this star intended to look at the science of what was going on, what that meant, and then I speculated, within reason, about what it could be to balance out some of the sensationalist content that was floating around YouTube at the time, but I also made sure to leave open all possibilities so long as they were possible, and that includes the activities of alien civilizations. That remains just as possible today as it was 6 months ago. But now we have the opposite effect in the media, where the clickbait headline is mystery solved. This has happened to some degree before with this star, where someone releases a paper that does not provide a complete explanation, which is precisely where we are at right now, and the media goes nuts thinking it is complete and then goes out claiming that the mystery is solved, only to have the whole thing go out the window a month later when some other development comes along that changes the landscape. That's probably going to happen again, and I suspect it will continue that way for years to come. So, mystery solved? Not really. We're still very far from that. But I caveat, as I've done throughout the odyssey that is KIC 8462852, that it is highly likely that this is a natural phenomenon, and I personally favor dust in some strange circumstance, or group of circumstances, of a type that we simply haven't seen before. This all stems from NASA JPL having finally weighed in after taking a look at the star using the Spitzer and Swift missions, looking at infrared and ultraviolet respectively, along with visual observations from an observatory in Belgium, link to the press release below. The press release bolsters recent developments that push the explanation of the phenomenon towards dust, which in all honesty has been one of the more likely culprits all along, but it does not address one key aspect of this story, the short-term dimming events, some of which have been really strange, more on that in a minute. What they found was that the phenomenon orbits in a roughly 700-day orbital period, and dims less in infrared than ultraviolet. That screams dust, as opposed to larger solid objects. This is a hit against the alien megastructure concept, at least in the form it was originally presented, the construction of a Dyson swarm or similar activity. In that event, you'd expect solid objects that absorb all wavelengths equally, but it does not kill that idea. If the star goes into another dip of 18 to 22%, especially like the day 792 event in the Kepler data, and it turns out to be solid, we'll be in very different territory, and it must be noted that the observations behind this press release were not taken during an event of that magnitude occurring. Really, this press release is based on the recent Meng and colleagues paper that I covered in the last update. In short, they conclude from the ultraviolet measurements that the dust must be very small, but still larger than dust you would find in the interstellar medium. If this is the explanation, it basically has to be this way. Dust smaller than a certain size would tend to get blown out of the star system pretty quickly. Dust larger than a certain size would uniformly block all wavelengths of light. Add that with a strong signal in ultraviolet, and the shoe seems to fit for dust. But this only affects the long-term dimming trend, as no short-term dips were occurring during the observations. And bear in mind, the short-term dimming events, especially the larger ones, were what put the star on the map in the first place. The long-term trend was a later discovery. That represents an Achilles heel here, because while it tells you about how the dust is during a non-dip period, it doesn't tell you how it acts during a dipping event, though in fairness, data from the Boyajian team on the recent short-term dips does also seem to suggest dust. But then you're left with figuring out why the dust clouds are so uneven, or whether something changes in the profile during a major dip, such as day 792 from Kepler. This brings into play a compound answer to the mystery, that swarms of comets are involved, and may actually be the source of the dust itself, perhaps tossed into the system en masse by a red dwarf that is known to be nearby. The problem, though, is that the dips in Kepler don't really fit the profile of exocomets, based on an exocomet study done by S. Rappaport and colleagues using the Kepler data, link below. Another problem are those very deep long-term dips of 18 to 22% seen by Kepler, and generally weak infrared emissions overall, at least as far as what's publicly out there on that. We really need to see more of those and get some spectra before we can start talking about the mystery being solved. As far as an alien civilization goes, as I said before, that has never been likely. It's an explanation that you can form fit to whatever you see, aliens of the gap, and that makes it problematic from the start. That said, megastructures aren't the only things aliens might build. If they wanted to mine a system for raw materials, they may well kick up a lot of weird dust. But this is speculation, so much more study of the star is needed before we get anywhere close to that kind of a conclusion. So, in short, we now have the best partial explanation yet as far as natural explanations go, based on some new and welcome data. But once again, like all other explanations, it has flaws and covers only part of the phenomenon. And if the history of the study of this star is any indicator, this star loves throwing wrenches into the works, and this may all look very different in a month or two. Thanks for listening. I am science fiction author and futurist John Michael Godier, currently wondering what any eavesdropping alien civilization thinks of our clickbait headlines. The humans spotted us. Wait, maybe not. And be sure to check out my books at your favorite online book retailer and subscribe to my channel for regular in-depth explorations into the interesting, weird, and unknown aspects of this amazing universe in which we live.